morning, students. Today we will read about the deficiency disease. You all know, whenever we fall ill, we suffer from a disease. Some diseases are caused due to some other factors like microorganisms. Means some diseases which are caused by microorganisms like bacteria, fungi, virus, protozoa. These diseases are of different types and they are communicable. Communicable means ek se dusre ko phailne wala. So whenever a person gets infected with suppose malaria, typhoid, jaundice or smallpox, these diseases are communicable because these are caused by the microorganisms. But in this video, we have to read about the deficiency diseases. Deficiency ka matlab hai kami. Means, if a disease occurs due to the deficiency of nutrients, then the disease is called deficiency disease. These diseases are non-communicable, means these do not get passed to another person. So if a person is suffering from a deficiency disease like anemia, khun ki kami, only he or she will suffer from this. The other persons which are close to him or her will not get affected. So deficiency diseases are non-communicable diseases. Non-communicable. मतलब जो पटता नहीं है, एक से दूसरे को जो फैलेगा नहीं, उसको बोलते हैं non-communicable. There are many causes of deficiency diseases. First one is the poverty. Poverty means गरीबी. In our country and in the whole world, there are many countries which are below poverty line. Means they are very poor countries. In our country also, many people, they do not get balanced diet. And as I have told you, balanced diet is very essential to keep our body fit and healthy. So first cause is poverty, in which poor people cannot afford a balanced diet and thus their body get affected with the deficiency. Second is wrong food habits. Wrong food habits are very common in nowadays society. You all are small children and you all love to eat the bakery items or pizza, burger. These things are not good for health. So, children of today's society are generally suffering from deficiency diseases. What happens? If they eat this type of food, junk food, they become obese. They only get energy, not the minerals and vitamins and proteins, nothing. So what happens? Children will become very obese, means mote ho jate hain. People, koi bhi, lekin bacche jyada hote hain. So children do not eat green vegetables, and the second cause of eating junk food is they do not get green vegetables and thus they suffer from many deficiency diseases caused due to vitamin and mineral deficiency. That will be taught you in next class. Wrong cooking practice is the another cause of deficiency disease, because in many houses people do not know how to cook vegetables and how to cook the food. Many food items are cooked in wrong process. Means we should not cook always by opening the food which is going to be cooked. So while cooking, we should cover there are three causes of deficiency disease. Now, students, we will discuss about the deficiency diseases, but first we will discuss about the most three important things which give us energy and growth, these nutrients. So first is deficiency of carbohydrates. What will happen if a person will suffer from deficiency of carbohydrates? He or she will have less stamina, means taakat. Stamina means taakat, because you all know carbohydrates are the energy giving food. So the person will suffer from less stamina. Second one is deficiency of protein. Deficiency of protein is very harmful, and it always mostly takes place in the small children, and the disease is called kwashiorkor. So kwashiorkor is the disease which is caused due to deficiency of protein, and the child who suffers from kwashiorkor will have retarded growth and in his body there will be no muscles, the skinny body, and no fat, because we do not get in proper amount the protein which is very essential for his growth. And third one is deficiency of carbohydrate, fat, and protein. You all know that carbohydrates give us energy, fats are also the food that will provide us energy, and protein is responsible for the growth. So all three nutrients which are very essential for our body growth and energy, if all the three a person will not get, the body will suffer from a disease called marasmus. Kwashiorkor and marasmus
dry or bigger.
children's body growth will not take place. Third, as the body growth will stop, new cells will not form. What will happen? The muscles of the body, the tissues of the body start destroying. So these are the symptoms of kwashiorkor and marasma. Hope you all have understood about the FEM diseases and deficiency diseases.
Calcium and phosphorus are very essential
child should drink milk every day, and from other sources like ragi, nuts, green vegetables, fish, meat, bajra, these cereals, we can also get these things, these minerals. Last one is sodium and potassium. Sodium and potassium are also essential for our body as they maintain our body water balance. Means how much water should present in our body? It is 70%. Not less than or more than. If the body will start storing water, what will happen? The body will swell. Means water it is. So it is essential to maintain these minerals in our body so that we do not suffer from these diseases. Hope you all understand. Apart from these, zinc, magnesium, chlorine are also minerals which are required for our body, and these we get from different food items. These are called trace elements. Trace minerals or trace elements, they are needed in very very less amount, and our body can get from this from the other food items. Now students, we will read about the deficiency diseases caused due to vitamin. Vitamin full I have not written. You also write VIT.A, means vitamin A. Vitamin A is a very essential for our eyes. Night blindness is the disease caused due to the deficiency of vitamin A. In this disease, what happens? Dryness of eyes and skin, and the person could not see in dim light. Means as the day turns into night, the sunshine will go, what will happen? The person cannot see. So this is called night blindness. So Hindi mein rasa andhi bhi bolte hain. From where do we get vitamin A? Vitamin D, A we can get mainly from green leafy vegetables, fish, egg yolk, milk and dairy products. Carrots are very important source of vitamin A. Sorry, I have forgotten. So carrots are very essential for our eyes. We should eat more and more carrots in winter. Second is vitamin. As I have told you, vitamin B contains 6 vitamins, 6 types. So here I have written all 5. One is lacking in for you. So vitamin B1 means vitamin B complex collectively is causes very very disease is related with our body function, means metabolism. Whatever we eat, it is digested. Then energy is released, the nutrients are absorbed in our body and so on. So this all process is called metabolism. It controls metabolism, and very very when a person suffers from very very, what will happen? Nerve inflammation. Nerves, we have nerves in our body, and digestive problem, then irritation in eyes and general weakness, loss of appetite and frequent headache are the main symptoms of very very. So here I have written separately, means most of the vitamin B complex are related with anemia. Means you will be you all are obviously in your mind, you all have a idea that madam has just now about the iron, and which is essential for to prevent the our body healthy. So vitamins are also essential for to prevent our body from anemia. Third is vitamin C. Vitamin C is especially found in citrus fruit. Citrus means fruits which are sour. Sour means khatta, like nimbu, narangi means orange, tomatoes, green chilies. These are the rich source of vitamin C. So vitamin C deficiency causes scurvy. Scurvy, spongy and bleeding gums. Scurvy is related with gums. Gums become swollen and start bleeding. And pain in limb means haath pair mein dard bhi hoga. Aur joints jo hai wo bhi infection bahut jaldi hoga. Kisi bhi tarah ka infection. So nowadays we all are at home due to corona, COVID-19 disease, and if you all know that every day we must take at least 1 milligram of vitamin C. So we should drink every day 1 lemon with hot water to prevent our body from corona. Vitamin D is a disease. Vitamin D causes a disease, rickets. Vitamin D is a vitamin which our body can synthesize, means form, in sunlight. It is also called as sunshine disease, sunshine vitamin. It is also called as sunshine vitamin. Means everyone should sit or stay outside their home in sunlight during morning. That you all know. Why? Because in sunlight, our body can make vitamin D. And vitamin D is essential for our body bone. Vitamin E is responsible for reproductive disorder. Means when a people becomes an adult and after marriage, if he has some problem, then this is called reproductive disorder, means formation of young ones. So reproductive disorder, if this symptom is RBC cells get damaged and loss of muscle, means body becomes thin and slow blood clotting. Blood will also clot very slowly. So these are the symptoms of vitamin E. From where do we get vitamin E? We can get vitamin E from cotton seed oil, milk, meat, milk, egg, cereal. And last one is vitamin K, which causes excessive bleeding, means hemorrhage. If anyone gets cut, his or her blood will not clot very fastly as a healthy person do. So what is the function of vitamin K? To stop bleeding. And if it is lacking, what will happen? Excessive bleeding will take place. So this is found in spinach, cabbage and other green leafy vegetables. Now I think I have explained it very nicely, and you will not face any kind of problem. If you will have, you can ask me